Hey, I'm Jake. Welcome to the Making a Website from Scratch video series. This is episode 5, where we have already created a website from scratch using HTML and CSS. We have added it to a Flask server. We have allowed us to do some cool stuff with templates. And finally, in the last episode, we created an SQLite database where we can store usernames and passwords. And as always, all of the code for this video will be down in the description below. So if you want to just grab some of the code and try it out yourself, go for it. In this video, we are going to allow a user to log in and maintain that user's session while they're logged in. It's going to be pretty awesome. So let's just get to it. All right. So one thing you're going to need now is you're going to need to install a new pip package. So pip install flask-login. And this is going to help us to be able to manage the login session for our user. We are then going to import a number of things. So from Flask login, we're going to import login manager, user mixin, anonymous user mixin, login user, logout user, login required, and current user. I know, lots of stuff, but it'll be worth it. The next thing we're going to do is under the secret key, our super secret key, we're going to go ahead and create a login manager referencing the login manager, and we're then going to initialize it with our app. Our app has not run yet, again, because it's not down away at the bottom, but that's what we're going to do first. By the way, you're probably not going to see the console too much here because it's just always on, but I have already started the server. There might be some instances where you need to kill the server and restart it, but you probably don't because of Watchdog. So, yay. All right, next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to create a representation of a user using a class. So we are going to have this here, which is a class user mixin. So this means we are extending the user mixin class, yes. And here we then are going to allow you to have an init where it has a ID, a username, and a password. Now, if you actually look at our table for our user, that's exactly what we have. So this should basically be a row within our table. Awesome. Next, we're going to create a function that actually allows us to load a user. So we're going to call this load user. And this is going to take in a user ID because, well, we need to know which user do we want to load. And this is actually going to load the user from the database. So we're going to go ahead and paste in this code here, which is simply connecting to the database, creating a cursor, executing a select star from users where the ID is the ID. And then we are going to fetch one from that result. And then we're going to close our connection. Finally, if the user, which we got from our fetch one, is not null, so if it's that's what we're checking here, then we're going to go ahead and create a user passing in the 0, 1st, and 2nd element. Awesome. So in this case, if the user exists, we're going to get a user object back. If it doesn't exist, we're going to get none back, meaning the user is not found. One other thing we're going to do here, though, is we are going to add a decorator to this. We are going to add @loginManager.userLoader. And what this is going to allow us to do is it's going to allow the login manager to be able to load a user given a user ID by default just within the login manager. So it'll make a little bit more sense soon. All right, but in order to actually log in a user, we need to, well, have a login page. So I've already created a new page called login, and let me paste in some code for how we're going to do this. So you might notice that this code looks very similar to our registration page, and you'd be right, because it's almost the same. The main difference here is actually I have this static.style.css wrong. So let me get that and fix that. Done. But the main difference here is that we are posting our form to the login page or the login route, I guess I should say. So that means we now need a way to not only render this, but also handle that post. So let's go ahead and create that. So we're going to go under our register here, and we're going to create a def login. And we are going to add another app.route login, and then methods and we're going to do git and post. Oh, we don't need that. And I somehow started another version of Python. All good to go. Awesome. All right. So by default, what we want to do is return render template, and we're going to return the login template, right? Login.html. So already by default, this should work. But one issue is we don't actually have a way to get to this page without a user going to the URL and typing /login. So let's update our navbar to include this. So I mainly just showed this header name stuff before, just kind of to illustrate that you can do something like this. And we'll do something like that pretty soon. But I'm going to get rid of this for now. And instead, we're going to add in an ahref, and we're going to have it go to login. And it's just going to be a class nav item, just like the others. Nav item. And oh my God, I can't type anything. Login. Now let's do the same thing and create one for logout as well. We're not actually going to do anything for logout yet, but we're going to need it eventually. Okay, great. So now if we now go back to our website, we can now see there is already a login and a logout. And if we go to login, we come to this login page. So far, so good. Next, we need to add to our login function in order to actually make it do anything. So I'm going to paste in a bunch of code and we're going to go over all of it. So let me grab this code here and paste. So first things first, if it's a post request, which means we have clicked login because it is sending a forms post to our server, which is again a post request, we are going to get the username, we're going to get the password, we're then going to connect to the database. We've kind of done all this before. We are then going to use our cursor execute to select from there where the username and the password equals what the user has provided. Eventually, we're going to make this a little bit better because you should never just store a password in plain text, but we'll improve that later. Then we're going to do user equals cursor fetch one, just like we did up here for this load user. And then we are going to create a user object. And finally, we are going to do login user. And this login user, again, comes with this Flask login. And what this is going to allow us to do is it's going to allow us to actually reference a logged in user as though it's from a session. So we're passing this user object so we can use it throughout other calls. So we're not going to do that too much in this video, but just trust me, it's kind of setting us up for the future. I just hit my chin on my mic. My bad. Okay, cool. So we have now logged in, presumably. And we're going to go and actually show that that's working. But first, let's go ahead and create a logout. So we're going to do logout. Then we actually don't need anything because this is just going to be a page it's going to go to. So logout. And all we're going to do here is do logout user. That's it. Pretty simple. Then we're going to do flash. You have been logged out. Just that. So that way we know that the user can see that they've been logged out. Then we're just going to return them back to home. So we'll do redirect URL for home. Awesome. So one thing we should do, I think I've actually already done it, is I've updated home to also have this thing that will show flash messages. So if you were following along from last video, maybe go ahead and update that as well. Sweet. So now this should work. So let's give it a try. So let's go to our site. And we can refresh here and we can try and log in. Jake, test 123, log in. Oh, I probably haven't actually. One thing that I noticed is that I haven't actually added this flash messages to the login page. So when I tried to log in, I realized that this is a new database where I haven't actually registered yet. So that's why it wasn't working. So first let's register, Jake, test 123, and we'll register. Registration successful. Now let's go to the login page and we can do Jake test 123 and then click login. And now we see login has been successful. So I know we still show login and logout, and we'll actually improve that so we can know if the user's logged in. We can show some special information because we know they're logged in, and then we can log out and actually, you know, make it so you can't get to some pages because you're not logged in. So we're going to do that, some of that stuff in the next video, but that is all for this video. So we have handled some basic login stuff. If I added all of this together, it would probably be a super long video and I don't think anyone would watch it. So yeah. So that's all for this video. If you liked it, please drop a like down below. And if you want to see the next video where we're going to continue this, then consider subscribing and ringing the bell down below. If you like videos like these, then you might like this video right over here. At least YouTube thinks you might. So if you do, go ahead and click it. Anyways, have a good day. Bye.